God bless, God bless, God bless. How's everybody doing today? I am Jamar Grimsley, and welcome to Get Right With God. Today, I just felt in my spirit to worship, to just bless the name of the Lord, to just honor him and appreciate him, and just talk about, you know, how good he's been, y'all. You know, just worship him and honor him for all that he does, what he's doing and what he's going to do. How many know God is always up to something? He always looking for a way to bless us, y'all. He always looking for a way to keep us, always protect us and move us to another level in him and deliver us and heal us and set up. Like, he's always looking for a way to do those things for us, y'all. So we must appreciate him and thank him and honor him and let him know how much we love him. How many know that when the praises go up, my God, guess what comes down? Nothing but the blessings of the Lord come down in the name of Jesus. So y'all, I don't want y'all to just watch and listen, but tap into this, because it's truly something that is spirit led, and you will feel the presence of the Lord meet you where you are. So don't just watch, you know, just, you know, get into it with me. Get into it with me, all right? So, Father, we thank you on today, Lord. We thank you for your grace. Father, we thank you for your mercy. Lord, we thank you for all that you do, Lord. We thank you for what you've done, God. And Father, we even thank you for what you're going to do, Father. I pray that you would just continue to cover us under the blood of Jesus, Lord. I pray that you would protect us, God. Help us to keep our minds stayed, Father, and focused on you. Father, you're so good to us, Lord. You're better to us, Lord, than we are to ourselves, Lord. And we just appreciate you on today, God. Lord, if we had 10,000 tongues, God, we still couldn't thank you enough, God, for how good you've been, God. Help us to stay connected to the vine, God. Father, I thank you, God, for sending your son to die on the cross for our sins, God. Oh, you didn't have to do it, God. Oh, but you did it because you loved us, God. So, Father, help us to appreciate you in all things, God. Help us to not just appreciate you for what you do, but for who you are, God. Father, we thank you for keeping us, God, even when we was in our mess, Lord, when we was running and rebelling and doing what we wanted to do, knowing that you was not going to be pleased with it, God. Father, you still kept us, God. Father, we thank you for your patience, God. Lord, we thank you for your patience, God. Oh, we so glad, oh, that you are not like us, God. But you're patient and kind, God. Lord, we thank you for your grace. Oh, we thank you for your mercy, God. We thank you that your mercies are new every day, God. Oh, Lord, you're so good to us, God. Oh, help us to always appreciate you, God. Help us to always give you glory, God, but never to steal your glory, God. Oh, but to give it to you, God. And Father, help us to know that whatever you allow to go on in our lives, God, Father, that you got our best interests at heart, God, and that you won't put more on us than we can bear, God. Oh, so help us to trust you, God, even through the hard times, God, even through the bad times, God, even through the rough times, oh, God. Help us to know, God, just because you said in your word that you would never leave us and that you would never forsake us, God. We have to stand on that right there, God. Father, if we don't have your word, then we don't have anything, God. Father, I pray that you would help us to read our Bibles more, God. I pray that you would help us to pray more, God. I pray that you would give us a zeal and a hunger, Father, like never before, like for righteousness, God. Just as the deer pant after the water brook, oh God, let our souls pant after you, oh God. Lord, I pray that you would remove people from all of our lives, God. Those people that will hinder our walk with you, God. Let them be removed in the name of Jesus, Father. We don't care how much painful it's going to be, God. Lord, you see beginning from the end, God. And if there's something that we're not seeing, oh God, that you know, God, break it up in the name of Jesus. We don't need it, oh God, and neither do we want it, God. Help us to seek first the kingdom of God and your righteousness, Lord. And then let us know that only then and only then will those things, God, would they be added unto us. Somebody asked, what are those things? That marriage that you want, my God, my God. That child that you want, my God, my God. Your ministry will take off. Oh, rabashata. Your finances, your business, your health. Oh, karabashandia. But you gotta seek first the kingdom of God. Oh, rabashata. Which is the way God does things. You know, we can't do what we want to do, but we gotta do what God wants us to do. Above anything else. Oh, kananabusha. And then that is when the blessings will begin to flow. Father, I pray that you bless us, God. I pray that you protect us, oh God. I pray that you would have angels encamp around us, Lord, just keeping us safe from any and all harm, hurt, and danger of any kind, God. Oh, rabashatarakandia. I come against the spirit of laziness. I don't know who that was for. And I come against the spirit of procrastination. That's for somebody right there. Oh, my God. Father, I pray that you would give us supernatural strength, God. Strength to move forward, God. Strength to do it when we don't feel like doing it, God. Oh, rabashata. Help us to step out in faith, God. Oh, believing that you will show up for us, God. And you'll show up every time, God. Oh, rabashando robosa. Oh, yes, Father, we trust you, God. We lean not to our own understanding, oh, God. Oh, but we acknowledge you in each and every one of our ways, God. And then and only then will you direct our paths. Oh, yes. Order our footsteps, God. Oh, down the paths of righteousness, Lord. Father, for those that are watching and those that are battling and struggling with any sins, God, secret sins or sins, Father, whatever it is, Father God, we know that it's nothing too hard for you, Father. So I pray in the name of Jesus, that you would strengthen them now, God. Somebody. Oh, my God, you've been struggling with the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over. And you're sick and tired, but you're bound. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Father, whoever that was for. See, whoever that was for, God said that for a reason. He wanted to locate you today, and he wants you to know that that thing is about to expire. Harabosaya. Enough is enough. See, Satan is just, I'm tired of Satan. I'm tired of him. I'm tired of him. Tired of his deception. Tired of him aggravating and tormenting the children of God. You know? I'm tired of them, y'all, trying to kill us, you know, steal our faith, destroy our faith, you know. I was telling somebody this, the whole reason that the devil bothers us, anytime, anywhere, anything he does to us, he doesn't want us to get close to God. Anything he does, his whole plan is to take you off the road of righteousness. Because he know once you get disconnected from God, oh, rabashata, that he got to have a field day with you. Oh, but you can't be disconnected from God. But when you are, when he gets you disconnected from God, he going to have his way in your life. I'm telling you. It's sometimes we may go 2 or 3 days without praying or 2 or 3 days without reading the Bible. Next thing you know, the devil's in your mind. He got you doing ungodly things, but it's only because you disconnected from God. You know, stay in connection with God. That's the key, y'all, is prayer. Because let me tell you, when the devil tries to throw tricks at your mind, right? But you've been in prayer. Because let me tell you, this is the truth, and I know you guys can relate to this. But sometimes the devil knows how to throw these darts. Now you think these are your own thoughts, but it's not. These are not your thoughts, but it's the devil sending thoughts through darts and arrows through your mind. Because he gets through us through the mind. That's how he gets to us, is through the mind. So when he shoot, don't you want to go get a drink, you know? But you think it's your own thought now, but it's not, but it's the devil that's bringing those evil thoughts to your mind, you know? That's why we got to cast those things down and bring them under the obedience of Jesus Christ. I do not receive that, you know? It's not you. It's the devil. But when you have not been in prayer, when he sent that thought, next thing you know, you just doing what he told you to do. If he told you to go fornicate, if he told you to go masturbate, if he told you to cheat on a tax form that you know you didn't or you didn't qualify for that, but maybe you put some stuff that, like all of those things are the devil. That's not even you, but the devil is using those sinful things to keep you bound, you know, to keep you bound. But he can't do it if you don't touch. If you don't touch his stuff, he cannot bother you. Do you know that? But the moment you begin to sin, you give him legal right to just flood in. And every demon that can come, they come right in. You know, the Bible says that when a demon is able to come back to a man, after it left, it's coming back with seven other demons, even stronger than itself. You know? So that little thing that you're indulging in, you won't get free because you've opened up the door for the devil to just continue to come in. Like, it's like permission now, you know, but when you don't touch his stuff, when you stay away from sin, he cannot come in your body. He can't come near your dwelling, you know. He can try, but he won't succeed because you've been, now you can't just be free and not sinning. You have to still have a relationship with God. You got to still read your Bible. You got to, you know, because those devils will come back. And it didn't even say, but he going to find seven other demons even stronger than itself. So it didn't just say, I'm going to find seven other demons. It's going to find seven other demons even stronger than him. Oh, Karabashandia, my God. Oh, Rabashata. Have you ever went off track? Next thing you know, you was doing everything in the book, but you was living a righteous, holy life. You was doing what God wanted you to do. But just because you sinned, you haven't went to church, you don't pray no more, you don't read your Bible no more, you're just out here doing what you want to do, but you look at it and be like, how did I get here? But you know how you got there is because you played with sin. The Bible tells us not to give them a foothold, which means don't give them anything to be able to get, you know what I'm saying? Don't give them nothing. Don't give them nothing. Not even something on TV, because sometimes, let me tell you this, and this was one of my little things that I had. You flipping through the channel, you're just looking for something to watch. But say something pops up, which is like erotic, or, you know, you see like a sex scene or something. But see, you got to keep on going, because soon as you see that, the devil, psh, go back. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's going to send that, psh, go back. Like, he knows what entices us. So if we got a sexual weakness, the moment that thing is there, he knows how to activate it and turn it on. Unless you've been in prayer, then you can fight and resist the devil, then he'll have to leave, you know. But if you stay, because let me tell you, once you go past it, now it's in your mind, like, God, I want to go back to that, I want to see what they was doing. And but you know, it's the devil, psh, psh, psh. You know, but if you've been in prayer, you'd be like, Satan, I rebuke that, like, you know, easily. Like, I don't fall for that. I rebuke that trick right there. I see what you're doing, and I'm not going to fall for it. You know? So, yeah, y'all. But that prayer, somebody needs power to resist the devil. But God is saying, I'm going to set you free from that. Your deliverance is coming very, very soon. But see, what you got to do, though, you have a part to play. You understand? Like, you can't believe, think God is going to do the whole thing, but you have to resist, even though you want to do it, whatever it is, even though you want to do it, you know God is not going to be pleased with it, or you know you shouldn't do it, but don't just do it anyway. You know what I'm saying? You got to resist. Even though you want to do it, I'm not going to do it. I want to do it, I'm not going to do it. I want to do it, I'm not going to do it. Like, when you do that and you begin to show God that you're serious and you want to be free, I'm telling you, he will meet you there. Ah, but he won't just snatch the whole spirit away. He won't snatch the whole demon away. But you have a part to play, and he'll meet you there. When you begin to show him that you're serious and you do your part, he'll help you then. Oh, glory to your name, Father. We thank you, Lord. And we just thank you, Father. And those Father, those that are watching, God, for you know, oh Rabashata, you know everything that we go through, God. You know what the enemy is doing to us, God. And Lord, we rely and we depend on you, God. Oh, yes, God. You said we can call on you, God. In our time of trouble, oh, God, you are the very present help, God. And Father, if you don't do it for us, God, if you don't deliver us from these spirits that are keeping us bound, God, if you don't do it, God, then it will not be done, God. So I'm crying out right now for your people in the name of Jesus, God. Send angels, God. Angels of healing, God. Angels of deliverance, God. Send it to them now, God. In the name of Jesus, I come against addictions. I bind the spirit of addiction in the name of Jesus. Every stronghold, I command it to break in the name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of distraction. Father, send positive people in their lives. See, there's some of you guys that had a good relationship with God. I mean, a good one. But now you don't even, it's like you don't even acknowledge him. You don't barely reckon. Like, it's not like he used to be. Oh, it's not like he used to be. It's not like it used to be. But God wants you back today. Father, snatch him out of the hand of the enemy, God. Father, we need you, God. We can't do it without you, God. We need you, God. Lord, you're our only hope, God. Father, your power, God, oh, exceeds that of the enemy, Lord. Oh, in the name of Jesus, God. Help us now, God. Help us now, God. Father, give us a hunger and a thirst for righteousness, God. Oh, like never before, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rabashata. And those that are watching, it's not by chance, but God knows what you need. Oh, he knows what you need, even before you ask, even before you make it known. Harabosaya. He know you need prayer. Let me tell you this, right? I'll tell you this. The Bible said that the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous man are the ones that avail much. But I want to say this, right? And this is for anybody. I feel it's for somebody, you know. But a lot of times when we're living in sin, right? In a secret sin, like nobody knows. Like this thing you doing, nobody knows. Sorry, excuse me, guys. This thing you doing, nobody knows about it. Not one soul. You're just doing this on your own, and nobody is aware, you know? Whether it be cheating on, I don't know, husband or wife, or whether it's masturbation, or whether it's drinking, or whatever it is. I don't know what it is, but you know what it is. So whatever that secret sin is that you're doing, right? And I have to share this because I'm trying to help somebody. Whatever that secret sin is, right? The Bible says that pray for one another. No, it says confess your sins one to another, so that you may be healed. Confess your sins one to another so that you may be healed. So the secret thing that you are holding to yourself and that you don't that you can't tell anybody about, the devil is having a field day with that right there. He's having a field day because he wants you to be so ashamed that you would never tell anybody. And as long as he got you living in secret, as long as he got you bound, and as long as he got you living a life of shame and that you won't tell anybody and you keep doing it, he got you exactly where he wants you. He got you bound by a stronghold. That's where he exactly got you, right there. You bound. And that's where he wants you. He don't want you to tell anybody. Oh, but if you tell them, they're going to judge you. You know they ain't going to approve of that. Why would you tell them that? You just going to make them angry. They're going to think, oh, you perverted. Or they're going to think, oh, you supposed to be trying to play church. You supposed to be a man of God, or you supposed to be a woman of God. Please, we all got something. Like, I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like, so nobody should make anybody feel judged. Nobody should make anybody feel condemned. No, we're supposed to help one another. You know what I'm saying? And the Bible says that confess your sins one to another so that you may be healed, right? So confess your sins. What it says, confess your sins, it's talking about confess them to people. Like, tell somebody about what brother, sister, I'm going through this right here, and I need you to pray for me about it because I can't overcome this on my own. So that person, once that person knows, see, nobody knows. Let me tell you, prayer is the vehicle that God uses to move on somebody's behalf. So if nobody's praying for you, God is not going to move. That's why he has to lay it on somebody's heart for them to pray for you. And they'd be like, I don't know why, but I was just praying for you this morning. Because God knows what you need. He knows what you're going through. But like I said, you have to ask him to show you somebody, you know, that'll sincerely pray for you. Because like I said, the devil don't want nobody to pray for you. He wants you to just think in secret and shame and just live like that and just be bound and I ain't gonna tell nobody. That's what he wants. But see, you gotta find those things in the Bible. What do I do in such and such situation? See, yeah, so you have to kind of study the word, and because the word is going to tell you how to live your life. It's going to tell you what to do. It's going to tell you how to fight the enemy. It's going to tell you about the love of God. But if you don't read it, you would just never know. You understand what I'm saying? You would just never know. But you tell somebody what you're going through. I'm gonna tell you this. I told my pastor, like, this was many years ago, but I was on drugs, but nobody knew. I was still going to church. I was still active in the church, and I was still participating in the activities. But when I left, it was drugs, alcohol, you know? And I did that for such a long time. And sometimes you get so, it's like you get tired. It's like a cycle. Y'all know what I'm saying? It's like a cycle over and over. The cycle that don't end. Like, you don't even want to do it, but you kind of find yourself doing it. You know what I'm saying? And it goes like that for years and years. So sometimes I just got tired, and I just told my pastor, I said, And the devil had it in my mind. See, this is what I'm saying. That devil is so deceptive. So he had it in my mind. How you going to tell him what you're doing? You know, like, why would you tell your pastor what you're going to do? And he going to kick you out of the church, and he going to rebuke you. And so I'm thinking that, and that's why I can't tell him, you know. But let me tell you, one day we was doing something with a Colt drive or something, and it was just me and him. And he said, well, son, how you doing? I said, everything's good. Everything's good. And he said, okay. Well, that's good. But somehow we was talking of something, and it's like the Spirit of the Lord just, I ain't going to say made me say it, but it just kind of forced out. I said, yeah, Apostle, I'm dealing with such and such and such. But it was the opposite of what the devil had me thinking. When I told him, he was like, don't beat yourself up, son. Everybody got something. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that right there was the opposite. Like, I could have bet 99.9% that was not his going to be his response. But it was the devil that had me thinking that. Ha, karabo shanda. My God. See, when he can get you alone, he can keep you in isolation. The devil got you where he wants you. My God. But as soon as he said, don't, it's okay. Don't beat yourself up. God knows we sin. God knows we mess up. But now I could pray for you about that. And let me tell you the truth. Couple of days later, I didn't have a desire for alcohol. I didn't have the desire for drinking. After I was doing it every day. But it is because his prayers for me. You understand what I'm saying? So when he tells God, I pray for Jamar, Lord. I pray that you would just deliver him from that abuse, that alcohol abuse. I pray you deliver him from those bondages. I pray you deliver him from everything that's keeping him bound, God. I pray that you break every stronghold over his life. I pray that you break that addiction of alcohol. Break that addiction of cigarettes. Father, heal him, God. And so when my pastor is praying that, oh, you don't even know it, but in the realm of the spirit, something is breaking. But if I never told him, if I never tell him, he won't be able to know what I'm going through to pray for me effectively. Oh my God. See, this is for somebody that's playing and dealing with a secret sin. You tell God, Father, lead me and guide me to somebody that would pray for me about this thing. Because I'm bound and I don't want to do this, God. I'm tired. Oh, Rabashetere Kandio. Tell him, I'm tired, Father. I'm tired, Lord. I don't even want to do this. So you, God, show me somebody who I can go to. Show me somebody that would sincerely pray with me about this thing. But you don't want to go to anybody because sometimes you tell somebody stuff and then you hear it somewhere else from somebody. But you didn't tell nobody but this person, so how do you know? So then you go back to the person you told. Well, how did they know what I told you? Oh, well, I don't know. I don't know. No, you told them. So those people, you can't even just tell anybody. Pray that God will show you somebody. It could be a pastor. It could be a friend. But somebody that you know is not judgmental. You know what I'm saying? But even as I'm saying this, God is bringing it to somebody. Like God is flashing a person before your mind right now of who it could be that you would be able to tell about this thing so that they may pray for you about it, you know? Because prayer is the vehicle that God uses to move. So the devil don't want us to pray. He don't want us to pray for one another because that's going to spoil his plans. Man, he better get out of here. He better get out of here. He make me so mad sometimes, y'all. Well, all the time, you know, because he just want to keep us down and want to keep us in a low place. Just want to keep the body of Christ from ever rising. You know what I'm saying? He want to keep us arguing and fighting, division and fussing and backbiting and talking about each other. And it's just not good. It's just not good. But we don't realize that a lot of times the devil is using us. Like we think, oh, this is just the way it is and this is the way I feel about it. No, but it's the devil that's using you, that's throwing them darts and them arrows in your mind to gossip about people. And I don't know, those things, we need spiritual discernment. So you guys, I just want to pray for you guys really quick, and then I'm going to go because I believe this message has accomplished what God wanted it to accomplish. See, it started off with just praise, like just prayer and praise, and see how God knows how to locate somebody and flip the whole mess. It was just that, and he turned it into kind of a message. You know what I'm saying? So when God does something like that, when you plan on doing one thing and then God takes it another way, that means that somebody needs what you're, like, somebody needs to hear that thing that he's going to take another way. So when he takes it another way, whenever it takes a turn from the praise, then somebody better listen because God is speaking right there. Whenever it turns from what the original thing was, you got to pay attention right there. But Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for these, your people, oh God. I pray for those that are watching, those that are listening, Father, even those that will catch this later, Father. I pray in the name of Jesus that you would strengthen them, God. I pray that you would give them power. Oh, karabashandi arabashandu rubosa. Give them power, God, power. Power to resist the temptations of the devil, oh God. Father, we know that is nothing too hard for you to do, Father. Give them a fresh anointing, God. Anoint them afresh. Receive that in the name of Jesus. Father, may they testify, God. Father, may their lives not be the same after they watch this video, God. Father, I send the fire and the power of the Holy Ghost to their homes right now, Father. Let it destroy everything in their homes, Father, that is not of you. Every evil presence in the name of Jesus. Let every portal, God, every portal with the enemy is entering into their homes. I seal it right now with the blood of Jesus. Father, I speak peace into their homes, peace into their minds, peace into their families. I come against that spirit of discord and division in the name of Jesus. Father, give us a hunger and a thirst for righteousness like never before, God. Do it for him in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Father, we thank you that it's already done. Father, we believe it and we thank you in advance, God. Oh, that it's already done, Lord. We give you the praise and glory. Ha, we give it to you in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. You guys, I pray that you guys received something from that. That was truly from the Lord for somebody. You know, it was truly from the Lord for somebody. So I thank you guys for watching. I am Jamar Grimsley, and this is Get Right With God. If you guys want to email me, my email address is getrightwithgodministries1@gmail.com. Or my website is getrightwithgodministries.com. Or either there's a place on there where you can send prayer requests. So if you want to email me prayer requests, but if you want to go to the website and send prayer requests, it's fine. You can send it there. Or again, you can email me, Jamar Grimsley. I'm sorry, getrightwithgodministries1@gmail.com, or my website is getrightwithgodministries.com. All right, and make sure you guys subscribe to my channel. Make sure you guys share the video. Make sure that you invite others to subscribe, okay? All right, God bless y'all. I love y'all. This is Jamar Grimsley. I'm out. Y'all be safe.